special talk on a special topic, exciting discourse with various guests, and conclusion of related subjects. Yes, Topic Talk.
Namaskar, good evening viewers. It's me, Dilmon Pun, on Topic Talk tonight. You are watching this special program on DTV. So dear viewers, we have today a very special guest in my studio joining with me. So who has been quite expert in academic field. So before starting the program, let me tell you something about the introductions of my guest. He's a teacher, he's a lecturer, he's a trainer, and some more. So he has been indulging in so many professions, being a one person. So let me tell you something about his professions, where he has been, you know, indulging in how many colleges and how many training centers and how many schools. So first of all, he is a lecturer of Kanti High Secondary School for plus two level. Secondly, he is the principal of Active Computer and English Language Institute. Thirdly, he is the trainer to air hostess at Sahara International College of Aviation. And lastly, but not the least, he is an English lecturer at Canon College. Viewers, a man of letter, I'd rather say. So he is none other than Ankit Giri. Welcome to sir.
Thank you. Sir. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody.
How are you, sir?
I'm fine. Thank you. What's about you?
I'm also fine, sir. So, sir, my first question to you tonight is that, so you being, you know, involved in so many colleges and institute, so, you know, tell me something that how do you make 24 hours into 48 hours? Do you have any magic wand?
No, not at all. Actually, I believe on work. I think work is worship. So I like to utilize my every moment. I get up early in the morning. Then after I go to one college, that's a Kanti College. That's what you can say, secondary school. Yes. Where I teach their English subject for the plus two students. After that, after my lunch break, I just go to the other college. That's a Canon College. And the rest of the time, I just give the time for the vocational trainings. And then my institution also. In that way, I just like to use my every moment in proper way. Let's say that.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. So I got it. Okay, sir. It's so fine. So being a one person, you have been indulging in so many institute and college. So it's amazing, sir. So secondly, I'd like to ask about your personal life. That means, sir, about your schooling and about your college. So would you tell us, all the viewers, that where did you study previously in your schools, about your college? Would you give some highlights of your background?
Okay, certainly, Dilmon Pun, sir. Actually, I was born in a very ordinary family in that's remote part of Gulmi district. By this one village is called Chapaile. At present, it is in Malika Rural Municipality, ward number 5. I completed my elementary course. This means up to 8th class. I just studied in local school, Sri Chapaile. Lower secondary school at that time, now it is high, this one secondary school. Yes, then after I completed my what is called this secondary level education from the next village, yes. That is called this one Ghamir from Devistan Higher Secondary School, a Nepali medium government school. And then after I set out my journey to Butol for higher educations, I came to Butol. Yes, there I completed my master degree from English literature, you can say language and literature. After that, I just got my 1 year education training also, that we call 1 year BEd course, the passing IELTS, this one appearing IELTS, that I involved in so many institutions.
Yes, sir.
In that way, this I studied all in that one government school and government colleges in my life.
Thank you, sir. So, sir, one question is still stuck in my mind. So, you have been from government school, you passed out, you know, your school, your college from government school.
Yeah.
And you know that the condition of government school is not so encouraging in terms of, you know, English.
Yes.
First thing is that there are so many labs, there are so many drawbacks which I see in government school. The first thing is that, you know, the environment of English is completely a kind, you know, negligible, you know. It's such an, you know, most of the, you know, teachers or, you know, students, the environment of English is completely nil, sir. And secondly, the medium of language is Nepali.
Yes.
So, how did you come out to be an English lecturer from such, you know, studying from government school or colleges? It makes me surprised, sir. So it seems like that, you know, a lotus is sprouting out from the muddy pond.
Let's not say that. I got some sort of environment when I was still a child.
Yes, sir.
When I was still a student of class 6, my eldest brother, his name is Dhanu Giri, and he is the principal of local school at present, secondary school. He became my English teacher. This means he came as my English teacher. He guided and inspired me, not only as an eldest brother, but also as the teacher, as an English teacher. And that's my English became quite a little bit stronger in comparison to others. Because I got the guidelines at home as well. In the school, my own brother was an English teacher. And then he lit a candle of the, what is called, thirst for the knowledge. This one, he inspired me that I should learn English in any cost. And later on, when I just came to higher education, this means plus two level, that we used to call that one PCL, permanent certificate level that time. Just now we have got plus two level at the moment. After passing my HLC in 2059, Vikram Sambat, I came to Butol. And still, I just studied in government school, I have said already. There also, I just selected OPT English, optional English, as my major subject. And a kind of interest, a kind of passion for English grew. I started making lots of preparations, self-practice. And then I studied myself. My teachers also guided me, some of the inspiring gurus like Jiblal Sapkota, and so many other Vishnu Pohel sir, and then Narendra Chhatri sir, and so many inspiring gurus guided me. And then after they said, yeah, Mr. Ankit, you have to do well, you have to do good. They inspired me. So these are the fuels, for me. So I am here a little bit. I have to do lots of things because I'm still the student.
Saying called, where there is will, there is a way.
Yeah.
So you got so many support.
Yeah, I got a support.
You know, from your home and from outside as well. Therefore, you are a fine lecturer today.
Good
lecturer today. Okay, sir. Let me ask the next questions. So being a lecturer, you teach several students.
Yes.
So how do you assess, you know, teaching English to students, particularly whose, you know, base are very weak in English?
Definitely, we Nepalese people, we use English as the second language. I hardly have found any person who uses English as first language. All of the students speaking and reading in Nepal, they use English as second language. And some of the ethnic groups who has got their own language, they use English as third language. In this situation, teaching English has been so much stumbling problem, that stone like that.
Yeah, of course.
And then teaching to the students, to the plus two level students, is very tough work, very challenging works. That I said, we have to teach in the classroom, understanding the students' level. Then I must say that, the course content is so much lengthy.
Yes.
We have to finish in time. If we don't finish in time, people may say this person, this teacher is not teaching in proper way, proper, that's one's speed. Then if we just, we know, just being an English teacher, I know everything. Just how much exercise we have to give, then what sort of conversation we have to make, and what sort of educational materials we have to give. For any examples, we have lots of videos.
Yes, sir.
English, there are in English literature, there are lots of videos. If we take to the students to the lab to watch all the videos, there may not be time, because we have to, after all, finish our course in time.
Yeah.
That's why English teaching in plus two level to those students who are from government Nepali school, that is the very top work. That time, especially, we have to, after all, we have to try. That's we just, as an English teacher, as an English lecturer, I just give them simple vocabulary. I just inspire them to learn themselves, to read themselves, so that they can find. And by simplifying, that's in short, by simplifying the methods, by encouraging them to do themselves. And sometimes by designing the model answers, I guide them. And just I have been somehow successful in this case, I should say.
Yes, sir. Nice, sir. So that means you got so many techniques to handle.
Let's not say so many, but long experience in these sectors.
After so experience teaches you.
As a plus two teacher, I have been teaching for the last 5 years. With this half decade, I have learned something, and I have been attempting to learn more.
So nice, sir. So, sir, my next question is related to the course. You said the course is so vast. So, on one hand, so our students, they are so poor in English. Secondly, the course, the content of the course is so vast.
Yes.
So, being a teacher of English, so he finds, you know, in a state of confusion, in a dilemma, what to do and what to not to do.
Yes.
You know, whether he should carry out the lesson first,
yes,
or he should go, you know, slowly.
Yes.
If he go very fast, you know, then you know, student, they don't understand anything,
yes,
and simultaneously they write nothing in the examinations.
Yeah, they won't.
And on the other hand, if the teacher is slower, if he go, you know, slowly with the course, then the content of the lesson don't finish on time. Finally, the administration, the school will blame that particular teacher, saying that he's a slam teacher, he's a, you know, lazy teacher,
yeah,
who has not finished the course on time. So, on this particular note, so what do you want to say, you know, about the syllabus, about the content of the course, you know, about the curriculum of the course?
Yes, actually, as you have said, the course is very lengthy.
Yes.
That time, in the case of school or college, we have some team of English teacher. I am one of them. We sit together in departments as a faculty members.
Mm-hmm.
We sit together and we manage and we discuss. We have talk. How can we handle the situations? There can be one way. That's we omit some of over theoretical unnecessary topics, and which are highly important topics, which are likely to come in the examinations. Not like that examination oriented, but the most practical topic we select.
It should be examination oriented also.
Yes, examination oriented also we have to, because somehow, not all the time, but during the examinations time, we have
examination
to be examination oriented. And as you have said, that's one curriculums.
The curriculum,
it is,
yes,
very lengthy.
In all the subjects.
Yeah, it's a very that's one lengthy curriculum. Not only, especially English, it has been designed not only targeting the Nepalese speakers, not only South Asian speakers. The course seems as if it has been designed for those students who are speaking English, who has been who have been speaking English as the first language. In that case, the curriculum designers, they must be very seniors, they must be very experts,
experienced.
They should understand that this course is very lengthy. So let's say I propose, let's not say I suggest them. I am so much junior in that way. So no, I just suggest, I suggest
we can give
them,
the feedbacks.
Yeah, they should minimize the course. So unnecessarily theoretical course, they should minimize. For an example, I will just give you an example of class 11. Yeah. As an optional English teachers, there are three books. The one is Outline of English Literature, that is the history. Another one is Reading Between the Lines. Another is Mosaic. And this Outline of English Literature, this means students of grade 11, they are the beginner initiators, they have to start the history, basic history of the world in English literature. Isn't that tough work? So in that conditions,
I agree with you.
Students cannot handle the situations. And those students and the government of Nepal also, so for an example, OPT English, that's when their government on the education ministry, or you can say a government of Nepal, has designed that students securing some grade score can take major English as optional subjects. But when they admit in major English subject, they cannot handle in first time. That time we have to do lots of exercise. If the government of Nepal and the education ministry can minimize the course and make it more practical, that would be good. That I suggest, or whatever you say, that I propose them.
Yes, sir. I totally agree with you. You know, too long course, you know, so can't be finished on time.
Yes.
And I think it's a burdensome students also, but learners also. Okay, sir. Next question, which I'd like to ask, is about the communications, you know. So it's a, you know, very true in everywhere, in all school and colleges, that the communication is something a stumbling block for the students. Most of the students, they cannot, you know, articulate their minds, their thoughts into words through communications. So, you know, communication is something a very, you know, major issues, you know, sir.
Yes.
So being an English student, so he or she has to be, you know, very good in communication too. But it's something lagging somewhere. It's lagging.
Yes.
Where do you find, you know, this drawback? What kind of tips you want to give to those students?
Speaking is a problem for students of Nepal, because firstly they cannot speak English properly. I don't say to all the students, there are very brilliant speakers also.
Yeah, yeah, brilliant speakers.
Brilliant speakers also.
But I'm talking of the average students.
Most of the students, they don't have the speaking capacity. So, as a teachers also, we know how students can improve their speaking capacity in the classroom. If they are asked to do lots of exercise, if they are given many opportunities to speak in front of the mass, and if they are created what is called situations, if they are created a chance to speak themselves, like a conversation, group talking, they can learn speaking English fast. But that I had said you earlier, if we start making all this arrangement, that sounds wonderful, but we don't have time. Because we have to finish the course.
Yeah, yes.
We don't know from where the questions for the examination can be asked. So for that, we can do one thing. We can arrange some of the additional classes, like that speaking classes, for writing classes, some
writing
additional
classes.
By arranging some of the speaking classes, we can encourage the students to speak. Though I don't say we don't have totally any programs for them. We have lots of programs like the speech competition, debate competitions. For them, these types of programs are only for those students who have already the knowledge of speaking. But those students who are feeling shy and nervous, that's when they are sitting back, they are not included in this type of system.
So what to do for those chunk of students who are, you know, feeling some kind of hesitation, not speaking, you know?
Yeah,
administration. I'm talking about the average students.
Yeah,
school and college, what they do is that they select, you know, particular group of students who, you know, speak, who can communicate all the time in all the competitions.
Yes.
So what happened that time? The student, those who, you know, feeling shy, they're lacking back.
They should be given a chance to speak. Every student should be given the opportunity to speak.
Yes.
For that, the school should manage the situation, or college should create the situation, very suitable arrangement for them, so that even the shy student, even the nervous student, can get a little bit confident.
Yes, sir.
And then, just as you said, some of the speaking tips.
Yeah.
The students, there is a saying, practice makes a man perfect. There is not any alternative way than making lots of practice.
Yes,
and if the students are inspired to learn, they are encouraged to learn, and then after, if they do lots of practice, obviously their speaking can be improved.
Yes.
Secondly, they should make some iron will. Iron will plays very vital role. There is one saying in English, if you have goal mind, you have gold mind. This means if you have particular goal, it is like that you are rich, then you have some target. So students should set some goals. Yeah, definitely I'm going to speak. I'm going to handle these situations. I'm going to speak on the stage. I am also not less than other students. If the students make an iron will or goal to learn English, they can speak English fast. In similar way, students should be some collaborative. They should be what is called more practical. Then they should be studious. Yes, and then if they are studious, cheerful, they can learn. And beside from this, they should have the habit of taking suppers. For an example, there are many people in our locality, we have got better English, then we feel hesitation, we feel shy and nervous. We don't like to expose our problems. So I think just I have got some problems in listening music, but I feel shy to say I don't have, I have some problems. In that situation, without feeling shy, fear and hesitation, students.
Sorry for interrupting.
Yes.
So what I have seen is that even the talented student,
yes,
so who write quite excellent in examination,
yeah,
they also feel some sort of shy, you know, they, you know, feel some kind of, you know.
Yeah, that's all about the
agitations.
Environment. Because I have seen lots of things. If somebody speak English, that's one, yeah, this English man is speaking. So that's why instead of encouraging the students, there are many people who are discouraging. For that one, students, especially the administrations, English teachers, and other teachers, they have to initiate from themselves. If the environment is created,
yes,
if the environment is created, and then self-respecting, if somebody speaks English, there should be situations. We should not demoralize or discourage him or her. Instead, we should say, yeah, well done, young man, you spoke English well. You have to, come on. That's once. If we encourage students, and if we ask other students also, yeah, speak English like him, encourage. If you commit mistakes, don't get afraid with it. Yeah, you can come in.
Yes,
you can. Then if we do like this, obviously they can do a little bit better.
So what I, you know, think is that, yes, sir, the environment should be created.
Yes.
English spoken environment.
Yes.
In any college or, you know, schools should be created.
Yes.
And second thing is that, you know, student should be encouraged.
Yes.
To speak, you
encouragement.
Know. Encouraged to take part in extracurricular activity, whether it's literary activity or any competition activity, all should be given chance equally. Okay, sir?
Yes. Yeah, you're right.
So my next question is that, sir, as far as, you know, I know you have been a favorite teacher of your students.
Let's not say that, but I try my best.
So give me some mantra, you know. So how can one be a favorite teacher of students?
There are not like mantras, but teacher should be frank, cheerful, and first of all, he should have the passion for teachings. If the teacher is passionate for teachings, very keen interested for teachings, and if he has good knowledge over particular subject matters, and then if he or she understands the psychology of the students, demand of students, then after obviously the teacher can be favorite teacher. Sometimes it is somehow what is called very idle world.
Yes,
that's one's for, because some of the students, they think that if the teacher says a joke all the time, less playing a lot, and then encourages to go outside, yeah. Then after that can be said best teacher.
Okay, sir. So my next question is, so since you have been an IELTS teacher, IELTS trainer, and teaching to various students, so now this become a trend that many of the students, they are setting going outside, you know, for abroad studies. So what is this IELTS is all about?
Very briefly, IELTS, International English Language Testing System, is a testing system of English. This is worldwide trusted method of testing English.
Yes,
whether any student or any person who wants for migrations can handle the communication or not. Those students who are willing to set out their journey to foreign country,
yes,
the kind of course, especially those students who go to Australia, America, then after this type of course can be done.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, sir. So, sir, my final question is that what kind of, you know, suggestion do you like to give to our audience who are watching you tonight through this show?
Hello, audience. I should like to say that English is not a challenge. If you are inspired, if you try. So, you should think that I should speak English. I should handle the situations. If you understand English, you can somehow understand the world. If you try also, you can understand the world. So keep on trying, keep on practicing a lot. One day English will be in your sight. You will be one of the good speakers. You will be good users of English. There are lots of good things, like a magic of words. The words English has some magic. So that magic you can get the mastery one day.
So
keep on trying, keep on watching.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining me tonight on my show and make this show something a grand success, sir. Thank you very much for joining with me.
Thank you very much.
So, viewers, I'd like to wind up my show here. So next day, next week, we'll meet on the same time on the same channel. Till then, goodbye. Thank you very much. Good night. Namaste.
Special talk on a special topic, exciting discourse with various guests, and conclusion of related subjects. Yes, topic talk.